Each photo tells a unique story. And each story becomes a stunning photo.
Eine Geschichte zu erleben war mir nicht gut genug. Ich musste sie leben. Realität zu inszenieren, das war mein Ziel.
Hannes Schmid takes us to the most exciting locations in the world. Where other photographers reach their limits, he goes a step further to create images that have left their mark on the memory of entire generations. Treat your eyes to an amazing journey.
Switzerland stands for tradition, quality, and neutrality. Hannes Schmid transforms these social values and responsibilities into his works. His untiring curiosity and risk-taking prompt him to create images. He is an artist whose path to finding his obsession has been unconventional.
Dieses Auswandern nach Südafrika, das war für mich dieser Schritt in diese Freiheit. Dann diese Zeit, diese 4 Jahre Afrika und diese Zeit in Südostasien, das war meine Lehre als Fotograf. Aber ich habe nicht des Bildes willen fotografiert. Dieser Weg zu diesem Bild, das war mein Erlebnis. Alle anderen Fotografen oder Bildschaffenden, die haben immer für dieses Resultat gearbeitet. Ich nicht.
After leading such a life, Hannes Schmid found entrance into an utterly new family. The tribe of the rock stars. He accompanied the biggest rock legends of our time.
Eigentlich habe ich 8 Jahre lang Familienfotos gemacht. Das Lustige war auch, dass meine Bilder niemand wollte zu dieser Zeit, weil meine Bilder waren nicht glamourös. Aber die Bands, denen haben diese Bilder gefallen, weil das war ihre Identifikation. Und heute, wenn man zurückschaut, ist das ein einmaliges Dokument dieser Zeit.
Hannes Schmid transformed the fascination for the trivial behavior of the bands, the uniform appearance of the fans, as well as the political revolt of an entire generation into a unique portrait of an era. In the 1980s, Hannes Schmid got discovered by the prestigious world of fashion and advertising. Contemporary critics were stunned by his new approaches, and he created extraordinary motifs and visions for renowned fashion designers such as Kenzo and Armani.
Aber ich war immer noch kein Modefotograf. Also ich war nur dieser Typ, der diese Realität, meine eigene Welt, für mich eigentlich inszeniert hat.
Hannes Schmid traveled the most extraordinary places on this planet, from the extensive steppes of Africa to the Earth's highest mountaintops. All of them served as backdrops for his pictures.
Das Lustige war, dass viele auch von den Topmodels immer sehr, sehr gern mit mir gearbeitet haben, weil die haben gesagt, ich kann da was erleben, das ich sonst nicht erleben kann. Das ist once in a lifetime.
This is how never-before-seen pictures came about, which had an important impact on fashion photography. That was Hannes Schmid's breakthrough. In his photographs, he masterfully achieved a balance between art and commerce. Hannes Schmid decisively shaped the cowboy of the Marlboro commercial, which became a legendary global icon.
Von mir wollte man keine Werbebilder. Man hat gesagt, wir brauchen etwas Frisches, etwas Neues, etwas anderes. Und so habe ich hunderte von orangen Bildern erzeugt, mit ganz einfachen Szenen, wie so Cutouts, wie so Scherenschnitte, oder? Und die waren natürlich sehr eindrücklich, vor allem auf Straßenplakate, und haben diese Wärme vermittelt, diese Nähe, aber auch unsere Sehnsucht wiedergespiegelt. Und das war genau das, was sie wollten. Und so habe ich über 10 Jahre dieses Image geprägt.
And that's how, for once, a Swiss person provided Americans with an identity which up to this day is firmly rooted in the minds of people. His stories not only influenced generations, but also helped small marginalized groups to attain global attention. In Singapore, Hannes Schmid, with an open heart and open eyes, encountered a phenomenon which instantly intrigued him. Hannes Schmid's project, For Gods Only, prompted the UNESCO to take a fascinating spiritual rite under its patronage. This is just one example for his increasing engagement for the preservation of such cultural happenings threatened by extinction.
Es war eine taoistische rituelle Opernaufführung, die nur für Götter, Geister und Deities ist. Aber das war für mich natürlich faszinierend, dass es Leute gibt, Menschen gibt, Schauspieler gibt, die ein Leben lang vor leeren Stühlen spielen. 2007 war die letzte Aufführung dieser Oper. Diese Geschichte ist verschwunden, die gibt es nicht mehr. Die Leute waren zu alt, sie konnten diese Aufführung nicht mehr machen. Und über mich lebt jetzt diese Geschichte weiter. Mein künstlerischer Gedanke dahinten war eigentlich, dass ich diese drei Formen der Kunst auf ein Blatt Papier zusammenführe. The Art to Perform, also die Kunst des Theaters, die Kunst der Kalligraphie und die Kunst der Fotografie, und das alles auf einem Blatt zusammenfinde, so dass es transparent ineinander schmilzt.
Transformation is a term best describing Hannes Schmid's works. Another proof of this is his oeuvre on the important topic of Formula One.
Ich wollte dieses Auto anders darstellen. Ich fand, dass dieses Auto ein Kunstwerk ist, aber nicht, wenn es auf dem Boden steht, auf 4 Rädern. Das gab natürlich eine komplette neue Vision dieses Formel 1.
Legendary photo series created a surplus value for the popular motor racing sports. And made people ask for more.
Ich würde gerne ein Auto in die Salzseen von Bonneville bringen und einen Landspeed-Rekord erstellen. Ja, der CEO war natürlich begeistert. Er sagte, super Idee, we're riding motorsport history. Und so, ja, genau. Da sagt er, talk to the team. Da habe ich gesagt, ja, willst du dann nicht wissen, was es kostet? Dann sagte er, ja, weißt du, Hannes, große Firma, große Träume. Fragst du, was ein Traum kostet?
Hannes Schmid was able to win over the team for his vision and accompanied the venture from its developing to its production stage. Through the feature film Bonneville, The Final Run, which evolved out of all of this, Hannes Schmid's idea of setting up a land speed world record shaped the history of motor racing. The mobiles are monumental design objects aiming to bridge differential cultures and to represent the cosmos as mechanism. Each part of the mobile is turning, leading to a perpetual movement expressing the Taoist principle of the constant transformation of life and human beings. The 5 mobile sculptures embody the 5 elements of the Taoist belief: wood, fire, metal, water, and earth. According to the ancient Chinese teachings of Taoism, these 5 elements stand for the 5 stages of the transformation of every living subject. the charity project Smiling Gecko serves Hannah Schmid to fight mistreatment and exploitation of Cambodian children and adults. In the framework of this nonprofit project, he perceives it to be his duty to meet with his social responsibility as an artist and make a contribution via his works and his competence. In Cambodia, thousands of people live on the slums and waste hills. They have nothing to eat but toxic food and become sick. They have no access to education, medical care, and clean water. 4.6 million people live below the poverty line of $1 per day. They work hours in factories for only a few cents without social and medical insurances. Due to their extremely poor situation, they become slaves of human traffic and prostitution. Hannah Schmid believes that the only way to improve durably their situation is to help them become independent. The Tuk Tuk strategy helps families to get an income of up to $300 per month. Men can support their family and send their children to school. 60 kilometers outside of Phnom Penh, Smiling Gecko is building the infrastructure for the Family Agriculture Project on 57,000 meters squared. Smiling Gecko works with local institutions in order to provide medical care for children and adults. Through these projects, Hannah Schmid and Smiling Gecko help to build a sustainable future for people living in poverty. Hannah Schmid, an extraordinary artist, looking far beyond the camera lens. His focus is always on art, and his fellow human beings are always close to his art. He's an artist who traveled the world and captured his personal treasures with his camera. He's a globetrotter who's found his place in a family at any place in the world, be it in Africa, Bolivia, America, Shanghai, China, or in the deepest jungle of Borneo.
Die ganze Welt war mein Zuhause.